All right, so it is Damien from Marketing Food Online, and in this video, we're gonna go over the 10 steps to create a granola business. If you've ever wanted to create a from scratch granola brand, I'm gonna give you the 10 steps that are the ultra important parts to think about before you dive into it. And we're gonna get into these 10 steps right now. All right, so it is Damien and we're back. And as I mentioned in the introduction, this video is going to be all about granola. Yes, I've had a lot of questions from my subscribers on how to get a granola business started. And is it something you can actually do from home? Or do I need to have someone create it for me, such as a co-packer? Or do I have to do it in a commercial kitchen? But before we do, definitely, if this is your first video, you want to hit the subscribe button and hit that bell notification for all of our new videos that we put up every single week. And if this video is helpful, as always, do give us a thumbs up. We appreciate the feedback. And any questions you have, let us know down below. So let's get into this really, really quick here. So the first thing you want to get off right off the top of your head is number one, your recipe. Figure out what it is that you're going to make. Now, you may be thinking, well, of course, Damien, I've already got a recipe figured out. If you have a recipe and it's something that you know how to make and make it very quickly or efficiently, that's going to be very important down the road when I get into a few of these steps near the end of the video, because I'll explain why. Now, number one, get your recipe, make sure it's perfected. If you can, create a few variations. Now, I've done a lot of consults with a lot of my clients. If you also are looking for 1-hour consultations, we have the phone consultations available. You can definitely work with me directly for an hour. You can check out the link down below the video for that. But many of them ask me, look, I have about 2 or 3 different flavors of my product. Is that something I can literally start an entire business with? The answer is yes. You can always even start one with literally just one flavor. I always recommend to have about 3, maybe at the most 4 or 5, but around 3 to 4 is a really good starting point because of the fact that the more that you offer your customers as a variety, the better off you are to entice them to buy your product. If you have a great granola recipe and you have one particular flavor, they're going to want some more. So the idea is, you know what? Hey, your one particular flavor is fantastic. Let's say the brown sugar maple granola. It's fantastic. Do you have any other ones that maybe have dried fruits or maybe some chocolates or some other type of nuts maybe incorporated into the granola? And most of the time, it's better off to have at least around 3 to even potentially 5 flavors, okay? And if you're going to do this business online, it's really going to make sense to have about 4 to 5 flavors, because you can go to eBay, you go to Amazon, you can go to Etsy, you can even create your own website. And on those places, you really need to bundle your product. Give them a variety. Give them a value pack. Make sure your customer has a lot to choose from, because that is a way to get them to come back for more. So if you're working with just 1 or 2 flavors, it's good. What's great is about 3 to 5. So number one, figure out your recipe. Make sure you can scale that recipe. And try to figure out a variety of flavors to get started with. Okay. Number two, where are you going to make the product? This is a big, big question, okay? So where exactly are you gonna make it? And most food businesses start from home, believe it or not. And there's a bulk of products that can be made from home, and actually granola is a really, really good one to do from home, because under the cottage food laws, most states, if not all of them actually, will allow you to produce specifically granola or even dried nuts or snacks or those types of trail mixes and things at home. So a granola business from home makes sense. Why? Because your investment is very low. You're not going to have a lot of overhead, okay? So where you're going to start at home, great. Well, guess what? You can do that, but it's going to limit the places that you can actually sell to, okay? So keep this in mind. Starting from home, you're going to do local farmers market, local events, fairs, or festivals. You're not going to have the opportunity to do business online. Food businesses online, shipping product interstate-wise, as far as over the state line from your home, is normally not allowed under cottage food laws. So where you're going to do it is very, very important, so figure that out. Number three, apply for your licenses and permits based upon your state, your county, and city. Now, the states are going to have certain licenses. They're going to have regulations and rules that you're going to have to follow. So permits and licenses that are going to be issued by the state, then the county that you actually live in, believe it or not, that county will have, potentially that is going to be where you're going to get your business license from, okay? Business licenses are normally issued by the county. Now, it trickles down all the way to the city. If you're, again, working from home under the cottage food laws, the city may have certain ordinances, rules, or regulations that will allow you to either do it, or they may allow you to do it, but you've got to get another permit from the city. So the county, the state, the city are three different things you want to think about. And that's going to be dependent upon your state and your county and city that you live in. So I can't necessarily speak on your county, but you need to Google that and find out what is the county requiring. And is there any potential license or permit that I must have in order for me to do this? All right, so next up, you want to incorporate yourself, okay? So now remember, a business license is one thing. Under the cottage food law, if you're starting from home and you're creating your granola, a lot of states don't necessarily require you to have a business license or even be incorporated. Some do. Now, I personally, for liability reasons, I recommend you incorporate yourself. You need to have a separate entity aside from your own personal life that's going to absorb any potential risk that you're going to have with this business. Food businesses do not need to be hobbies. People get sick and they can sue you. It needs to be considered a business, even though if your state does not require it under the cottage food law, incorporate yourself. And you can do that as an LLC, you can do it as a C Corp, S Corp, whatever entity status you choose. What do I recommend? Very simple, basic LLC. If you're not familiar with how to do this, down below the video in the description section, I'll give you another link. You can actually do it online. There's a multitude of companies that do it online. It takes you less than 15 minutes. But please, for your own safety and for your own security financially, create some type of LLC or some business entity. All right, so next up, food insurance. Yes, food insurance. If you are going to create a food product and you incorporate yourself as a food business, then you need to make sure you protect yourself even more with a food business policy, okay? Now, this insurance is not extremely expensive, by the way. For a home-based business, the average cost per year is between about $475 to about $600, $550, somewhere around there. But again, check out the descriptions below. I'll give you some other resources. You can check those. You can get a policy from one of the insurance companies that we actually deal with, as a matter of fact, allows us to pay our policy monthly. So it comes out to about $45, $46 a month, which is great because that way you don't have to come up with the entire amount up front. All right, so next up, how are you going to package your granola? So now, the bulk of granola products that you noticed obviously in the marketplace are normally in a bag, a Ziploc bag, some type of a zip top bag that allows the customer to buy it and keep it fresh by keeping it zipped up. Those are traditionally the best way for multiple reasons. Number one, having them printed or having custom printed on those types of bags are very inexpensive, as opposed to a container or some type of jar or lid that has something else to it. They get to be a little bit more pricier, but the bags are also lightweight. So if you turn this into an e-commerce business and you start to ship a product that's in a bag, it's going to be considerably lighter. Some people like to go over the top and they have these fancy glass jars or maybe plastic jars. Guess what? When you start to ship those, number one, they could break. Number two, they're very expensive because of the weight. And number three, a lot of customers don't have a lot of space for jars in their cabinet or pantry. So the traditional stand-up zip-top bag is going to be the best type of packaging for your granola. Now, not only that, but how big? How big are you going to make it? I personally would say go out into the marketplace, which would be a grocery store, maybe farmers markets, or anywhere that you see it, and see the sizes that are already out there. You don't have to reinvent the wheel and come up with your own size. Just kind of duplicate and mimic the sizes. Normally, you get anywhere from like about a 9 to 10 or 12 ounce bag up to potentially 16 ounces, okay? Granola is something that's also kind of larger in pieces compared to like mixed nuts or some type of a trail mix. So granola has a tendency to be a little bit bigger. So you might want to stick with a bag, and I would say about 10 to 12 ounces in weight, okay? All right, so the next question, logo, label, and branding. So if you've got a concept in mind, you've got a logo, maybe a really cool name that you want to trademark. And by the way, if you need to trademark, again as well, check down in the description. I've got a link for Inkfile that actually allows you to trademark your product for very inexpensively, but you can do it online in literally minutes. The process to get it approved does take a few months, don't get me wrong, but the application for the trademark is really quick and easy. So you want to come up with a logo. If you don't have a logo, you're not very artistic, you can check out our link for Fiverr down below as well. You can create a logo through Fiverr for anywhere from $20 to even $30 and get a reasonably looking good logo to get your business up and running. Now, Damian, why do you say reasonably good looking? Well, you can get a good label, a good logo to get started with. Don't think that you are in stone. Everything that you do is concrete, that you can't change or evolve. Down the road, if you want to create a different logo or a different look, you can. If you want to create your brand right out of the gate, then take some time working with a designer to create exactly what you have in mind or the idea that you have. Because as people begin to buy your product, that first impression is going to begin to start setting in for your brand. You want to create a brand, create it with a logo and have a label that looks fantastic, then just take your time doing that. But remember, nothing's in stone. You can always evolve and you can change as you go along. All right, so next up, you want to create a website. Now, you want to have an online presence. Now, if you're wanting to sell the product through the internet, obviously you're starting from home, but down the road you may be getting into a commercial kitchen, maybe you get a co-packer, and you can do the fulfillment through a fulfillment center, then you need to have either Shopify or a Weebly website built for you, or you can build one yourself. These website building programs and software have become very, very easy to use, very simple to interact with. You can build your own website through Shopify. Get some great pictures of your granola up there. Get some great titles and great description. If you've got a certain flavor or a certain history or story behind how you created your granola, you want to have that on your website. But if you're starting from home, you can't necessarily create an e-commerce website. You can create a more or less an informative website that's going to have information about your brand. And when you get into a place where you can logistically and legally ship the product over state lines, then you can transition that website actually into an e-commerce business. Okay, so create a website. Make sure you've got a lot of information. You can, again, do this on Wix, BigCommerce, Shopify, Weebly, or even GoDaddy. These are all great places to actually create and develop your own website. And that's the next step. Now, the next one after that is logistics. So this is the part I wanted to dive into a little more detail about. So if you're starting from home, there's actually four ways you can make your own granola. Okay, number one, start from home. We covered that, right? That's going to allow you to sell only locally, though, within your state and out of your home. Number two, you could rent a commercial kitchen and create your granola from scratch there. Bag it, mix it, whatever the process is for you to do that, you can actually do it in a commercial kitchen. But that's going to cost money. When you rent a commercial kitchen, of course, that costs money to do. You need to make sure that when you price your product, you're making up for the expense that you're investing in renting the commercial kitchen. So what's the third way, Damien? The third one is co-packer can make it for you. Now, I don't recommend a co-packer when you just start because you need to create some type of draw for your product, interest in your product. You need to create some buzz locally for it because if you have a great recipe for the product, right, and let's say you go to a co-packer and you're saying, you know what, I would love to have about 4,000 bags made, but where are you selling it? Well, I haven't started selling it just yet. And the co-packer is going to say, well, why am I making 4,000 bags for you if you don't even have the infrastructure set up? You don't have a website. You don't even have any logistics or any of that. That's not a good idea. If you start making your own batches of granola and you grow the business to the point where you can't make it anymore, that's when you contact a co-packer. Okay. Number four, you can start your own commercial kitchen. I mean, you could just invest and go out and buy a commercial space, get it licensed, inspected, and then just start making it yourself. So that's obviously a much more expensive endeavor, but I would recommend start at home, grow it, get some interest, and then you transition to a co-packer to make it for you or actually create your own kitchen and do it for you, okay? So number nine, the next, you want to create some type of presence on social media. I recommend every single one of them, LinkedIn, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, Twitter, everyone that you can think of and everyone in between. You need to have a presence online, not only with your website, or if you're selling it on Amazon or eBay or Etsy, that's of course having a presence on the line. But you need to have some type of social media presence, okay? And I highly recommend that you focus on maybe two out of all of them. And then those need to be the best ones that you put all of your effort and energy into. Facebook is a great one because of course, yes, you can run ads, but Facebook has a lot of other groups and other types of organizations and people you can connect with who are interested in granola, believe it or not, okay? So Facebook is a great one. For us, we love to use Twitter. Twitter and Facebook are the two that we focus on a lot, and LinkedIn probably is a close third there. Twitter is great because we can reach a lot of people instantaneously with the right tweets and the right hashtags, and in that method of doing it, it's brought us really considerably good amount of money, a lot of business. So between the two, that's what I would say. Focus on two of them and definitely have some type of social media presence, okay? All right, so in that is a wrap up for the basic steps to get a granola business up and running. Gives you some options, give you some ideas and brainstorm about what would be the best route for you to take. So if you have any questions about starting a granola business or any food business, let us know down below. If this video was helpful and tutorial as it is, let us know as well with a big thumbs up. And if you need any help, we do have consulting available. You can check out our website at marketingfoodonline.com. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching Marketing Food Online. And if you are looking to create your own food truck, start a home-based food business under the cottage food law,
franchise a food operation, start a packaged food business, private label your own food product, sell on Amazon, get your own online store, or sell food online. Remember to subscribe and check out these videos for more resources. Take care.